Hello dear viewers, today I will start with this birthday boy's picture with his birthday cake and his family waiting to celebrate his birthday. Now if he calls a few of his friends to the birthday, then out of the birthday cake that has been ready for him, he will get and his family will get a larger fraction. But his friends increase in number, then this fraction which will be available for his family will be smaller one. So this is the basis or the principle of today's topic, radioimmunoassay. It is an in vitro nuclear medicine technique, a non-imaging technique where nothing is injected or administered as a radioactivity into the patient's body. And this is one of the techniques I had explained or in a very brief way in one of my last presentations on non-imaging diagnostic nuclear medicine. Today, I'll be presenting the video on this topic. This was discovered by great scientists like Dr. Rosalind Yalow and Dr. Solomon Berson in 1959. The contents of this presentation will be: what is radioimmunoassay? What is the radioisotope of choice, iodine-125? Why is it so? The reagents, the principle, tubes in RIA, quality control, and the reference that I have used. Now, what is radioimmunoassay? It is a type of saturation analysis, a limited reagent or excess analyte assay in which the radio-labeled antigens and the specificity of antigen-antibody binding are used to estimate the concentration of biomolecules in body fluid like serum. For example, if I want to estimate insulin, then insulin is the biomolecule. Because it is antigen-antibody, we talk about the antigen as insulin as an antigen. Otherwise, it is not an antigen. But in this assay, as per the term, with this context, it becomes an antigen. Now, radioisotope of choice is iodine-125. Other isotopes were tritium, carbon-14, and iodine-131, while actually the most common or ideal isotope is iodine-125. Because its half-life is 60.2 days, convenient for shelf life of the kit. While its energy is very low and very safe to use, 35 kV, actually it is iodine-125 by electron capture. The decay is by electron capture to tellurium-125 metastable, and that daughter will immediately convert to tellurium-125 by 35 kV gamma emission. So it is as good as iodine-125 emitting 35 kV. So it is because of such a low kV, it has a simple and inexpensive counter that is needed to count this isotope. And it can be obtained by in almost 100% isotopic abundance, that is specific activity per unit mass. And so it also can be introduced into peptides very easily or with some modification to steroids. Now, what are the reagents in RIA? The tracer, that is the radio-labeled antigens, the antiserum, that is the antibody to these antigens, and the separation system can be second antibody, which is the antibody to this first antibody, which can pull down the complexes to the precipitate after the centrifugation. And then the coated tubes, which have this antibody, which can bind these antiserum and radio-labeled antigens complexes and keep them in the tube. When the tubes are inverted, the unbound will go away, while the coated tubes can hold the complexes. Now, the standard is the unlabeled antigens of known concentration and which can be used in the different aligots. Different aligots can be prepared to get the different numbers of known concentration of unlabeled means cold antigens. They are also called as cold antigens. Now, the different main requisites of radioimmunoassay are the micropipette, which gives accurate dispensing of the volumes, proper accurate volume dispensing. This is the centrifuge for the separation of the bound and unbound tracer. And this is the RIA counter to count the 35 kV iodine 125 emission, gamma emission. Of course, the tellurium 125M there in between. The analogies that I had shown in the first slide are like this. The radio tracer, the radio labeled antigens are this family and the birthday boy. And the cake or the limited antibody sites are this one, that is the limited antibody sites. Why? The friends are the variable antigen concentrations. Now, on this basis, the principle can be very well understood. What is that? That is the tracer and unlabeled antigens compete for the limited antibody sites. More is the concentration of the unlabeled antigens, lesser is the tracer bound to the antibody. So, this is the inverse proportion. Now, here, the graph of the bound tracer counts versus the antigen, varying antigen concentrations is plotted, and it is nothing but the dose response or calibration curve. If the counts from the sample tube is the Y, then the unknown concentration of the analyte from the sample is the corresponding X of the dose response curve. So the tubes in RIA for total activity, that is how much activity or counts have been in totally added, can be seen in this tube. Non-specific binding, where the first antibody, the antibody actually specific to this antigen has not been added. In the sense, anything else that the radio tracer is getting bound to, this has to be lesser, the better. The maximum binding or the beta B max or B zero, where the zero standard, in the sense the radio tracer gets maximum fullest opportunity to get bound to the antibodies. And here there is no competition in the maximum binding. And standard or calibrators, standard A to F, as I told you about the different aligots of the main concentration of the reagent, known concentration of the unknown, unknown concentration of the unlabeled antigens. The sample is actually the test samples. For example, I have put them as the 20 test samples if you have run along with the RIA, that is RIA curve test samples along with them. Here example I have kept as 20, and the quality control tubes, and that is quality control for low, middle and high range, where you know the concentrations but you want to get it from the assay. Okay, so this cannot be used as a standard. Even if you know the concentrations, you have, this is like finding out whether your RIA is going to give you this kind of answer. You know the results, you know these values of low, middle and high range, but you want to get it from the RIA that you have run. Now, how the quality control of this RIA, where you find out the percentage maximum binding, it should be 30 to 70%, and non-specific binding should not go beyond 10%. And the control samples, that is what I had talked about, was where analyte concentration corresponding to 90% binding, it's a low. Analyte concentration corresponding to 50% binding, that is middle, and corresponding to 20% binding, that is high ranges. So low, middle and high ranges. Now, what is the reference I have used? It is Radioimmunoassay Principles and Practice by the great scientists Dr. M.R.I. Pillai and Dr. S.D. Bandarkar from BAR Isotope Division, BRC, Bhabha Atomic Research Center, Mumbai. So the summary will be, what is RIA? Radioisotope of choice, iodine-125, reagents, principles, tubes in RIA, quality control, and reference that I have made.